SpaceX is about to embark on a new frontier, sending people into space. Elon Musk's spacefaring company has made its name sending cargo and satellites into the stratosphere for fee-paying customers. But a partnership with NASA means the firm will soon start sending astronauts to the International Space Station. On April 20th, the SpaceX Crew Dragon vehicle had experienced an anomaly, as the company called it at the time, on a test pad at Cape Canaveral in Florida. The explosion took place during testing of the thrusters of the same Crew Dragon spacecraft that flew the uncrewed Demo 1 mission to the International Space Station in March. SpaceX was testing the thrusters, including both the smaller Draco thrusters and larger SuperDraco thrusters, ahead of an in-flight abort test of the spacecraft, then planned for this summer. SpaceX revealed July 15th the cause of the explosion that destroyed its Crew Dragon spacecraft and delayed its first launch of humans to the International Space Station. It may take a bit longer than expected to reach this goal. Hans Konigsmann, SpaceX Vice President of Build and Flight Reliability, suggested on Monday, the 15th of July, that a launch could take longer than anticipated due to issues with developing the Crew Dragon capsule. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss SpaceX Crew Dragon astronaut mission, which may slip to 2020 due to the anomaly. SpaceX finally knows what caused its Crew Dragon capsule to explode. Let's get into details. NASA first chose SpaceX and Boeing for its commercial crew program back in 2014 after the pair unveiled its capsule designs. The agency revealed its team of astronauts in August 2018. However, delays resulted in the agency extending its Roscosmos contract in February 2019, pushing the deadline from November 2019 to September 2020. SpaceX completed a major milestone in March when it sent up 400 pounds of cargo in a Demo 1 mission. It was the first time that a commercial capsule autonomously docked to the space station. Ripley, a dummy that bore a resemblance to Snarban, was affixed with sensors to collect data about the trip. The test was meant to precede an in-flight abort test before moving on to a Demo 2 manned crew mission. SpaceX hit a major snag in April when a status test fire at Landing 1 in Cape Canaveral, Florida. The test was meant to focus on firing the Super Draco thrusters used during in-flight abort tests. On the 15th of July, SpaceX further clarified in a press call that the accident occurred during tests of the Crew Dragon's thruster systems in Florida. The capsule has Draco thrusters used to maneuver in space, as well as powerful Super Dracos. They would fire in the event of an emergency with the rocket to pull the crew safely away during a launch. Specifically, the April 20th anomaly occurred during the activation phase of the Super Draco thruster system, when it's pressurized and valves are opened and closed. SpaceX said the most likely cause of the explosion was when a leaking component allowed nitrogen tetroxide, NTO, oxidizer into helium tubes during processing. When the system was pressurized just before the planned ignition, a slug of NTO was driven at high speed into a titanium check valve, causing structural failure of the valve and igniting it, triggering the explosion. When you pushed the slug of NTO into the check valve, it basically creates an explosion, said Hans Konigsmann during a call with reporters. He said SpaceX, with the assistance of NASA, confirmed this scenario in testing at the company's McGregor, Texas test site. "We found out that when the pressure is pretty high, the temperature is high, and you drive a slug with a lot of energy into a titanium component, you can have these rather violent reactions." The initial tests of 12 Draco thrusters on the vehicle completed successfully, but the initiation of the final test of 8 Super Draco thrusters resulted in destruction of the vehicle, SpaceX said in a statement. In accordance with pre-established safety protocols, the test area was clear and the team monitored winds and other factors to ensure public health and safety. SpaceX noted the anomaly happened approximately 100 milliseconds prior to ignition of Crew Dragon's 8 SuperDraco thrusters. SpaceX said this reaction between the titanium and the NTO was unexpected, as titanium had been used safely over many decades and on many spacecraft from all around the world. This failure led to a wealth of data for future testing. The team has tweaked the design in a number of ways to prevent such problem from occurring again. This includes the use of burst disks instead of check valves to eliminate the possibility of any liquid propellant flowing into the gaseous pressurization system. The burst disk, which separates the oxidizer and fuel from the liquid, making Crew Dragon a safer vehicle. The hardware components needed to mitigate this problem are relatively straightforward, Hans Konigsmidt said. What may take more time is the process of checking other fuel systems in Crew Dragon for similar vulnerabilities, as well as characterizing the basic physics of the NTO and titanium that ignited in this situation. He said SpaceX was about 80% of the way through its investigation with NASA into the accident, with additional time planned to look into the physics of how it occurred. The investigation so far has relied on high-speed cameras that captured the incident, as well as various debris that had been ejected around the site. Another failure that same month only emerged during a Congress committee hearing. The team was testing the parachute system at Delamar Dry Lake in Nevada, looking at how the system works when one of four parachutes fail. The other three did not work as expected, and a test sled took some damage. William H. Gerstenmaier, who was the associate administrator for the Human Exploration and Operations Mission Directorate at NASA, described the failure as a gift due to the extra data. With this vehicle destroyed, however, SpaceX noted that the vehicle built for Demo 2, the first crewed launch, traveling to the International Space Station, ISS, would now be used for the abort test. Demo 2 will instead use the vehicle planned for Crew Dragon's first full mission to the ISS, Crew 1. Kathy Luters, manager of NASA's Commercial Crew Program, called the accident a huge gift for the agency, and for SpaceX since it discovered the flaw in a ground test. We had a lot of instrumentation on the vehicle, we had high-speed cameras, and we were able to get the hardware and the data. Through this process, we'll continue to learn things that will help us fly safer, so that problems with the spacecraft can be ironed out before any humans climb on board. Amid criticism about how NASA and SpaceX publicly communicated information about the anomaly with the public, Luters noted that NASA personnel were on console for the test and knew immediately what happened. She also expressed satisfaction with the pace and quality of SpaceX's investigation into the mishap, and that now was the time to be transparent about the status of the investigation. Neither Konigsmidt nor Luters would commit to a schedule for resuming test flights of the Crew Dragon spacecraft, including both the in-flight abort and the Demo 2 mission, which will carry NASA astronaut Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley. Prior to the accident, the Demo 2 mission was officially scheduled for late summer, but most industry observers expected it to slip too late in the year. Konigsmidt said work like replacing check valves with burst disks can be done at the same time as other activities that need to be completed prior to NASA's approval of the Demo 2 flight, like completing testing of parachutes. It's a parallel path, basically, to solving the remaining work that we have on Dragon in general, he said. Both said that the Demo 2 flight could still take place before the end of the year, although Konigsmidt acknowledged it was increasingly difficult to keep that flight scheduled for this year. I'm pretty optimistic at this point in time because we have a good path forward, Konigsmidt said in conference, but like I said, still not quite done. My emphasis is really on making sure this is safe by the end of this year. I don't think it's impossible, but it's getting increasingly difficult. Though Musk originally proclaimed in August 2018 that it could send humans into space by April 2019. Koenigsmidt's comments suggest that SpaceX's first human spaceflight may not arrive until late 2019. It comes after a Government Accountability Office report last month, which stated that both contractors have run into chronic delays. Boeing, the other contractor aiming to fly humans with its CST-100 Starliner capsule, is also expected to miss its deadlines. Time is of the essence. When NASA axed the shuttle program in 2011, it started sending astronauts to space station by hiring seats on Russian Soyuz rockets at $81 million per seat. That contract with Roscosmos expires in September 2020. And the Government Accountability Office has warned that NASA needs a backup plan in case SpaceX and Boeing experience further delays. The SpaceX will now be hoping things proceed smoothly towards the first crewed flight, and with any luck, we'll see it by late 2019 or perhaps early 2020. There's always a chance we're going to fly crew on a SpaceX vehicle this year, Luter said. Right now, we're paying very close attention to the work that's being done, coming out of the anomaly investigation, along with the other tests. She said that Behnken and Hurley had been briefed multiple times on the investigation during their regular visits to SpaceX. We're going to fly when we feel like the certification work has been done to be able to safely fly our crews, she added. I hope it's this year, but we're going to fly when it's the right time and when we know we'll be flying our crews safely. While SpaceX has yet to fly humans, it's already outlined far more ambitious plans. Its under-development Starship is expected to offer the ability to send 100 humans to Mars and beyond. The firm is expected to detail a full-size prototype later this year. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.